Hey, man. Just want to say, appreciate your time down here to be able to sit underneath you again, Brother Fletcher. And definitely glad to have you down. Don't know which direction to go. I'm wrestling with two things in my heart, amongst other things. But God say, set everything aside and still run the race for me, no matter what at you.
Amen.
But before I go where I'm going, I just want to pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you, Lord, for this time.
Yes.
And Lord, just pray for the Fletchers that you be with them in health, strength. Lord, that you be with his wife. You know these bodies, you built them, you made them, you created them, you formed them, you shaped them.
Amen.
And Lord, you can go in the very physical body and take care of it. Yes. You take care of the spiritual, I know you can take care of the physical. And Lord, we just set that before you. You heard the request. You know the pain. You know the situation. And may you watch over Brother Fletcher and Mrs. Sister Fletcher. May you give them safe travels and mercy as they travel back. And do know this, I do love them in the Lord. And thank you, Lord, for using them, the nuggets that they shared. Now, Lord, at this time, I just pray and ask you to show me which direction you want me to go here today. In Jesus' name I pray. And bless this house. Amen.
Talk about Jesus.
You know, we talked about generations and people and being humble. I always want to stay humble.
Amen.
If so, I want to stay humble. I want to stay humble. Amen. I want to stay part of that generation that want to have a love and an eye for God. I want to be part of that group in my heart, and start in the heart, that no matter what your storm may be, that you still stay with God. I think about a man in the Bible, no matter what his storm was, he still had his eye on God.
Amen.
I'm talking about a 2-in-1. We connect the dots in there. The 2-in-1. And I think about Brother Fletcher talking about vessels, bottles. God know that bottle what can be filled, and God know that bottle that's already filled.
Yes.
Some bottles filled, and it's already got concealment on it. God is not a thief. He's not going to go in there and break that open that don't want to be open.
Amen.
He know that bottle that's empty that want to be empty. He know that bottle that's empty. I just want to talk about that bottle. That it's a bottle that they want to be filled, but yet they don't know if that's the right solution to put in that bottle. Yay to the ones that say, whoa, I want to hope something ain't right about this. Whoa, let me keep on searching because I want the right thing to fill this vessel.
Amen.
Praise God. Thank God for that generation that have an eye to look a little further.
Yeah.
No matter what they storm may be.
Amen.
That's the inner eye. I want to do that.
Yeah.
But I want to talk in the Bible today. Let me scoot on over. Thank you, Jesus. Job chapter 2. Job chapter 2. 2:1 say, again, there was a day when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan came also among them to present himself before the Lord.
Amen.
I think about that verse. That verse hit me when I was in the Bradenton meeting. I was just thumbing through the pages, just thumbing and listening. Something hit me about this situation with Job. Job went to church. Sons of God, they went to church. But it was too present. And it dawned on me, who's the too present? A devil and them? No, it was them in the flesh. Two presents. Sons of men, let me read this, catch that again. Again, there was a day when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord. And Satan came also among them to present himself amongst them. Did I get that right? Verse 1?
Before the Lord.
Before the Lord. So it's two when we come before the throne of God. The new Adam that's in us and that old Adam in us. It's two. And it's one pulling against the truth and it's one trying to pull you away from that situation. It say here in verse 2, and the Lord said, and say verse 2, and the Lord, come on now, slow down. And the Lord said unto Satan, from whence thou comest thou? And Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the earth and from walking up and down in it. No matter where we present ourselves, even here under the truth, we got Satan running through and through, which that's that old flesh, want to pull you, want to torment with you, want to give you a deaf ear to the truth. And praise God, I can say we in a place where we can kill that old flesh. Oh, hallelujah, help me to humble myself. That's why we need to humble ourselves, because it is too present. We come here to place ourselves under the spout. We come here to place ourselves where we can get the truth to be an overcomer. Why? For what we already filled with. Sometime it needs to be emptied out. Sometime it needs to be made anew. I want to present myself as a new body with an open heart, open mind to receive a new cup of the fresh blood of Jesus. I want that renewing. Why? Because he can't work in old that said, I'm already sealed to what I want to believe. Amen. No, he want to seal. He want to put a new in somebody who have an open heart. He want to put new understanding, new nuggets, new ways, a different way of building in somebody who have an open mind, open heart. But oh, the old flesh there, the old devil there, had his eye on Job. All the sons of God was there. And God know who have his eye on him and who don't. Why, for the Bible says they met there. Sons of God met. Is that not what verse 1 said? They met there. And God knew, watch this. And the Lord said unto Satan, from whence thou, let me go to this. And Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and through the earth. Verse 2-3 I want. And the Lord said unto Satan, hast thou considered my servant Job, that there's none like him in the earth, a perfect and upright man, one that feared God and the ash evil? And in other words, he shone and put all evil behind. God knew the one that was an overcomer. And Satan also knew that flesh. Knew. And that's that old carnal nature. I believe that's an unclean spirit that will traffic through this land to enter into the body, to use it as use it as a vehicle to destroy you within. And then it'll use you as a vehicle to bring poison to destroy without. But praise God for that new Adam that came in to direct us, to rescue us from this. And so they had their eye on Job. He used Job as an example. For when you feel with my understanding, when you feel with my ways, that we could be overcomers. We could be overcomers of this flesh. No matter what storm happened to us, no matter what type of fire is burning around us, no matter what, if we take the closest thing by your heart and use it against you, that you can overcome. It says here, and still he hold fast his integrity, although thou moved me against him to destroy him without cause. 2-4 And Satan answered the Lord and said, skin for skin, yea, all that a man have will he give before his life. 2-5 But put forth thine hand and touch its bone and its flesh, and he will curse thee to thy face. 2:6 And the Lord said unto Satan, Behold, he is in thy hand, but save his life. And also say 2:7 So when Satan, what'd that say right there? 2:7 Y'all got 2:7
Yeah. So when Satan forth from the presence of the Lord. And smote Job with sword oils on the sole of his feet.
Unto his crown. Watch this. And he took him a posture to straighten himself withal. And he sat down among the ashes. 2:9 Then said his wife unto him, Does thy still remain thy integrity? Curse God and die. 2:10 But he said unto her, Thou speakest one of the foolish women, speaking. What? Shall we receive good at the hand of God, and shall we not receive evil? And all this did not Job sin with his lips. Let me tell you what.
Here's the key.
I want to be just like that, no matter what the picture may be, and all of us should have that desire.
Amen.
Because we got a generation that's out there. And you see that here with Job. It was too present. God knew the one that could be filled. God knew the one that had the tools. God knew. And Job passed the test. I want to be able to pass the test just like Job.
Yes.
And I want to be amongst that bride that'll give me encouraging words. Not everything that went to shambles, not get up and curse God. No, sir. We amongst a bride that could lift you up, that could be a crutch for you. And praise God for those meetings. I think those meetings blessed a lot of people. I thought those meetings broke a lot of chains. Did for me. And it's still breaking. Because I want to humble myself and be right in my heart, no matter what the storm and fire may be. Why? Because of Rico, I could be cheating somebody, shortchanging somebody. I don't want to shortchange somebody because of my situation. I want to stand strong like Job. No matter what come against me, no matter what it be against me, I still want to walk for my Lord.
Yeah, stand fast.
No matter what the storm may be,
amen.
I still want to go. Why? Because that's what God called me to do. Why? So that's what the flesh want to do, trip me up. The more I want to do for God, the more I want to do for him, it seemed like a bigger battle I have to fight. But praise God, when all hell come crashing down around me, I want to be as Job. And keep it going. And one thing about Job, it come a time when Job even realized it's going to just have to be about me and you, Lord.
Amen.
Me and you. Me and you.
Amen.
That's why he turned and talked. He talked to the Lord. It was just about him and him. Why? For his wife, she had a vision in the wrong place. But Job did. Praise God for example in the Bible. They realized that it was two in the presence. And praise God, I think I'm safe enough to say Job was overcome.
Right.
At that time.